Hello friends, today we will see how the algorithm affects the analysis of selection sort and insertion sort. Now what are these two terms, what are these two algorithms that we will see now. Now what is sorting to start with? Now in a simple terms, any sorting method in a simple real world example is arranging the input sequence in either the ascending order or the descending order, that is from a larger to smaller value or from a smaller to larger value. Now sorting is also defined as a process that organizes a collection of data into either ascending order or descending order. Now the different types of sorting methods we have seen in a general line, either we can make people stand from the height which is the tallest to the smallest or from smallest to tallest. Now in computers, how do we do it? Now the different sorting methods are, the first one is known as an internal sort. The few internal sorts are which uses the computer's main memory, that is they are done, the processing is done faster in the computer's main memory. And the second ones are known as the external memory, where we require an external device to store and to sort the particular data. Now what is a selection sort? To start with, the list, whatever is the input list, is divided into two sublists. That is, one is a sorted list and another one is a unsorted list. When we start with the input list, we take it at the complete list as an unsorted list. We find the smallest element in the list, that is the minimum element from the unsorted sublist, and swap it when the element at the beginning of the unsorted list, which means that when we sort for any input list, the first element is always considered as the minimum, as we do not know the complete list and what are the elements lying in that particular list. So we always presume the first element as the minimum element of the list. After each selection and swapping, the position of the sorted elements are fixed. When these are fixed, thereby increasing the number of sorted elements and decreasing the number of unsorted elements. As we do the swapping and we make the minimum element reach its fixed position, so we increase with time is a sorted list and reduce the unsorted list. Each time we move one element from unsorted list sublist to the sorted sublist, we say that we have completed a sort pass. And every time we make a position of a sorted element fixed, it is termed as a pass one for that particular sort, for that particular instance. A list of n elements always requires n minus one pass to completely rearrange the data. If we have n is equal to 5, then we will require 4 passes minimum to sort the particular data. Now we will see how the selection sort actually works. Now we have an original list which is comprising of 5 numbers, 25, 86, 56, 13 and 45. This is an unsorted list. Now we have to sort this particular list using selection sort. We have just seen the algorithm for the selection sort, that I have to find the minimum element. So step one is the first element is always considered as the start of the list and comparison starts from there. So here 25 will be considered as the minimum in the list for the starting purpose. Step two, find the minimum element from the list starting from the next element. If 25 is present at position 1, then we start searching and comparison from the second point or the second element. Swap the values of the first element with the minimum element in the list. that is from 86 to 45. We will traverse the list and we will find the minimum element in that unsorted list. If we see when we traverse that 13 is the minimum element in the list. So what do we do next? We say as soon as we find the minimum element in the list, we swap their positions. So we swap the positions of 13 and 25. So after the pass 1 of selection sort, my pass 1 list becomes 13, 86, 56, 25 and 45. Now this will now be an input list for my pass 2 of selection sort. So now when I go to pass 2 of selection sort, this was my original list. This is my pass 1 list, that is 13, 86, 56, 25 and 45. So now what do I do next? 13 is fixed at its location and I know 13 does not move anywhere. I am sorting from the smallest element to the largest element. So 13 is fixed. Now I start searching from 86, the minimum element in the array, and I find it at location number 4 with an element 25. So what do? I swap 86 with 25. So my pass 2 becomes 13, 25, 56, 86 and 45. So the pass 2 output list 13, 25, 56, 86 and 45 becomes an input to pass 3. So in pass 3 what happens? This is my sorted list. So 56 is my initial location and it is compared and found out what is the minimum element in 86 and 45. We find that the 45 is the minimum element. So we swap 45 and 56. So we get it as 13, 25, 45, 86 and 56. Now pass 3 output becomes an input to pass 4. And the list is 13, 25, 45, 56 and 86. Now we see as we had 5 elements in the list, but after 4 passes, my complete list is sorted. That is, I have been able to arrange all my numbers from the smallest to the largest in a sorted manner. So my pass 5 or the sorted list in the end is 13, 25, 45, 56 and 86. The total number of passes required are 4. Now selection sort, what are the various advantages of it? Selection sort, the main advantage of selection sort is that it performs well on small list. That is, when we have small amount of data, then the selection sort works the best because we find the minimum element in the list. So the best case happens is when that minimum element is found at the first instant of location. But if that minimum element is found at the last, that is known as what we've seen earlier is the worst case complexity, then it is an in-place sorting algorithm. No additional temporary storage is required beyond what is needed to hold the original list. That is, we don't require any secondary device as selection sort is always performed on a small list of data. So it uses the computer memory. So it is a type of an internal sorting algorithm. And the selection sort also works on if we find the minimum algorithm somewhere in the middle, then it comes with the average case complexity. Now, what is a disadvantage? As everything comes with an advantage and disadvantage. So the disadvantage of a selection sort is, the primary disadvantage is it has a poor efficiency in dealing with huge list of items. But we have already listed in the advantage that it works only on small list. So as my list size increases, the efficiency of my selection sort algorithm decreases. The performance is easily influenced by the initial ordering of items before the sorting process starts. If the minimum element is found at the nearest location, then the sorting algorithm gives the best output. Now, let us see the program for selection sort. Here, we've taken an example of a simple C program for selection sort. We have numbered the steps so that it is easy for each and every one of us to understand. As it is a simple C program, so the first step is to include the header file, the standard input-output header file. The second is the start of the main function. The fourth step, which is the variable declaration here, the array 100 is declared. That means it can store 100 numbers in an array. But we've seen an example of only 5 numbers. That was a simple example to explain. N is the size, I and J are the loop variables, and the minimum element taken is the min of a variable, which finds out the minimum variable, that is the minimum value, and swap is used to swap the two values. Next is a simple printf statement which tells you to enter the elements. Scanf, percentage n, it tells you how many numbers do I need to sort. I need to sort 10 numbers, then I have to input n is equal to 10. In our example, we have considered n as 5, so we will take n is equal to 5. And then we have to input the values. Here in the end, we have only given whatever is the size of my array, which is declared as array of 100. Now we vary the for loop variable for I is equal to 0, I less than n, I plus plus. If my for loop variable starts from 1, then the terminating condition should be taken as I less than equal to n. But since we are starting from 0 and we are accepting n as 5, so it has to start from till 0 to 4. So if we start from 1, then it is 1 to 5. Scanf percentage array of I. We input all the values in this array and we initialize I to be 0, as now we're going to see what is the next statement. Thank you.